everyone, and welcome to the second part of my TopModelBelgium Adventure. And in this video I'm going to talk about everything that happened after the final, so let's go! The first thing I did after the final is that I stayed home a week because I was sick. During this week a lot of journals called me asking for an interview, then I made a TV interview also. Then in March I met the minister of the German speaking side, two times he congratulated me himself. Also in March we had the TopModelBelgium dinner. I've met the other winners and we started like to know each other better. Then of course I had a lot of shootings of fashion shows because like if you have a title people are more interested in you. TopModelBelgium opened me a lot of doors. I had a shooting with Valentina from Liège. The photos were published in the Fatty magazine and like it's my first time being ever published in any magazine, so I was pretty excited. Then in April we were invited for the semi-final of TopModel International 2020. So TopModel International is actually TopModelBelgium, but they changed the name. I was super excited because just a year ago I was there doing the semi-final and now I'm there sitting and watching like the semi-finalists and yeah, it was a pretty cool time. During the break we went backstage and met the semi-finalists and they wanted to take pictures with us and I honestly felt like a little superstar because people were asking to take a picture with me and stuff and I was like super excited and happy about that. A few days after the semi-final it was finally our time for the trip. We went to Dominican Republic with two professional photographers, Philippe Toignon and Gaëtan Capito. And I was so excited because spending 10 days in paradise doing photo shoots, I mean, it was just a dream. When I didn't have photo shoots, I was sitting next to the pool, drinking my little cocktail, enjoying the sun. I was literally living my best life. We also traveled a lot around Punta Cana. We went on a few islands, we went on a safari tour, and we also discovered kind of the poor side of Punta Cana, and it really touched me because it's a poor country. We also went speedboating and it was the first time I was driving a boat. It was pretty fun but it hurted so much too because the boat was kind of jumping, so it wasn't that soft. During our speedboat tour, we also discovered villas of celebrities like Shakira and Michael Jackson, and I was impressed. We also partied a lot and we really got close with each other. But our trip came sadly to an end and we had to return back to Belgium. When we came back, I really focused on school and my exams because I missed 1 week of school and I had a lot of schoolwork to do, so I didn't went out for 3 weeks. But thankfully, I passed my exams without any problems. Then were the summer break, I had again a few shootings. Then in October, we had again a TopModelBelgium dinner and we received our photos from the shootings in Punta Cana. Then in January was the final of TopModel International 2020 and I was again invited with the other winners to see the final. So the final was again in Paris and when we arrived we met a lot of stars. Among them was Miss France 2018, Maeva Cook, and I was so excited to meet her because I really liked her a lot. Then we watched the show, we enjoyed it so much, and when they started to tell the winners we realized that this chapter of our life was over. And I was kind of sad because those were the best 2.5 years of my life. I've learned so much. So that's the end of this video, and if you have any questions about the whole contest, just watch my first video, and if you still have any questions, just come and ask me on Instagram.